Welcome to Star Wars Empire at War. Your goal in this game is clear. Take control of planets, conquer the Star Wars galaxy, and become the ultimate galactic commander. You have the ability to command everything from individual troops to starships and even the mighty Death Star as you fight on the ground, in space, and across the entire galaxy. How you do it is up to you. Will you repeat Star Wars history, or will you change it forever? The time to decide is now. The Empire is launching an assault on the Rebel base on Kashyyyk. To prepare you for the challenges of conquering the Star Wars galaxy, we are going down to the surface of Kashyyyk to show you how to take command of your land units to repel this invasion. Imperial forces have detected the Rebel presence here on the surface of Kashyyyk. You will need to gather your troops and defend the Alliance base on this planet. To accomplish this, you must command ground units like these Rebel soldiers who are currently on patrol to eliminate the enemy invaders. But before you begin, it is critical that you also understand how to use the command bar. To view the entire battlefield, use the mini-map located in the bottom left corner of the screen. Friendly units on the mini-map are displayed in green, while enemy units are red. The highlighted buttons represent advanced movement options, which are not covered in this tutorial. Please refer to the manual for a detailed description of their functions. Select the Rebel soldiers by left-clicking on them. Whenever a unit has been selected, an icon for that unit will be displayed on the command bar. You may view the status of your units or activate special unit abilities from within this area.
Be advised, the last transmission we received from the Lost Patrol Squad came from a position near your current location.
They can't be far from here. Let's find them.
Use your squad to search for the Lost Patrol by selecting them with the left mouse button and then right-clicking on the location where you want them to move. You can review mission objectives at any time by selecting the Mission Holocron option, located on the command bar.
Our transmissions are being jammed, sir. We must find the jamming device, destroy it, and report back to base.
Take control of both squads by holding down the left mouse button and dragging a box around them. You can select several units or your whole army this way. Locate the jamming device.
There's the jamming device. We must destroy it.
Use the selected Rebel units to destroy the jamming device. Hover your mouse over the jamming device and right-click on it to attack.
Sir, this jamming device has Imperial markings.
Acknowledged, Squad 3. All units return to base.
To move your selected troops to the Rebel base, you can give them movement orders by right-clicking directly on the battlefield map or on the mini-map.
We're tracking multiple Imperial transports from the east.
Get those defensive structures online now!
Build defensive structures to prepare for the incoming Imperial attack by right-clicking on the build pads located near the base walls, and then selecting a defensive structure to be built. Currently, you can build a turret and a Bacta healing station, but more structures will be available later in the game.
Take cover!
Bacta healing stations heal infantry units when they're within range of the station. To see the healing range of a Bacta healing station, simply left-click on the station. If your build pad structures are destroyed, they can be rebuilt, but remember, all nearby enemies must be eliminated before you may reuse a build pad.
Ready for combat.
Rebel scum!
Incoming Imperial forces!
Ready for battle.
Remember your training! Take cover!
Infantry units have the Take Cover ability. To use this ability, select an infantry unit and then click on the Take Cover ability icon located on the command bar. As an infantry squad takes casualties, the health meter for that squad will be reduced. Use the Bacta healing station to heal any wounded infantry units.
Incoming walkers!
All Plex soldiers, attack!
Every unit has strengths and weaknesses that can be exploited to win battles. Plex rocket soldiers are strong against lightly armored units like these AT-ST walkers. Command your Plex soldiers to attack the AT-ST units. To view this battle from a cinematic perspective, select the cinematic camera option located on the command bar.
The base is secure.
We need to reclaim all reinforcement points to our east. Otherwise, the Imperials will continue to attack our position.
Capturing the reinforcement points will prevent the enemy from landing even more troops. To capture a reinforcement point, you must eliminate all enemy units in the area and remain near the reinforcement point until it turns green. Note that every reinforcement point has a limit to how many units it can accommodate, denoted by the number shown. In Tutorial 5, we'll give you the opportunity to bring reinforcements into a land battle.
Area secure. Let's keep moving.
Ready to roll.
Incoming Imperials! Open fire!
For the Alliance!
Area secure. That's all of them.
Sir, I'm receiving reports that a massive Imperial fleet is en route to Kashyyyk.
This system is no longer secure. We need to evacuate this base immediately.
Retreating allows you to save your units from certain destruction whenever you're faced with overwhelming odds. Remember, you can always return to a battle later with additional units. Select the Retreat button on your command bar to take your remaining forces and regroup them on another planet.
Inform the main Alliance fleet that the Empire is aware of our presence on Kashyyyk. The rest of you, prepare for evacuation.
Yes, sir.
I can only hope that the Imperials haven't uncovered any other Alliance outposts.
Since you have successfully retreated from Kashyyyk, you can continue to command the surviving forces from that battle within the galactic view. This view allows you to manage the resources on all of your planets, including your economy, bases, and units.
We need to evacuate Kashyyyk and reinforce the main Alliance fleet at Bothawi. Prepare for departure by moving our ground forces into orbit above Kashyyyk.
Units within the galactic view are represented.
Good work. I'll transmit the system coordinates for Bothawi to you now. Stand by.
System control achieved.
Moving out.
There it is. Direct all fleets located on Kashyyyk to move to Bothawi. There they are. Now we need to join them. Give the order and we'll combine our fleets. Reporting for duty.
Welcome. I am relieved to see that you survived the Empire's assault on Kashyyyk, but our situation is still dire. You are all that remains of the forces there, and we have no other resources to draw upon. As you can see, the Rebel Alliance currently controls Bothawi. The Bothawi system is providing us with a modest credit supply. But if we are to withstand another attack from the Empire, we will need to find additional sources of income.
To obtain more resources, it will be necessary for you to claim another planet. Capturing a planet will increase the total number of credits that you collect at the end of every galactic day. It will also increase the total number of units that you can support. Ryloth is currently unoccupied. This means that it should be an easy planet to capture. Begin the process of capturing Ryloth by moving your forces into orbit above Ryloth.
Mission log updated.
Underway.
Planetary control achieved.
Let's take a closer look at Ryloth. To access a more detailed view of a planet, select the planet and then click on the zoom in icon located on the minimap.
Mission log updated.
You will need to build a barracks before you can recruit infantry. Building a barracks will provide you with basic ground defenses, as well as the ability to recruit infantry units. Switch to ground production mode by selecting the Ground Production tab. Then, build a barracks by clicking on the barracks icon.
Mission log updated. Constructing. Construction complete.
Constructing multiple buildings of the same type on a planet will give you bonuses, such as faster build times for specific units. But remember, each planet has a limited capacity for structures. You will need to create ground forces in order to defend the surface of the planet. Since you have built a barracks, you now have the ability to create more ground units. Switch to ground production mode by selecting the ground production tab. Then, recruit two Rebel infantry squads by clicking twice on the Rebel infantry icon.
Mission log updated, enlisting troops.
Reporting. Reporting.
You will need to build a space station before you can build space units. Building a space station will provide you with basic space defenses, as well as the ability to build space units. Switch to space production mode by selecting the Space Production tab. Then, build a space station by clicking on the Space Station icon.
Mission log updated.
Good. We will also need several space units.
You will also need to create a space fleet in order to protect the space around the planet. Now that you have created a fully operational space station, you have the ability to build ships. Switch to space production mode by selecting the Space Production tab. Then, build two X-Wing fighter squadrons by clicking twice on the X-Wing fighter icon.
Mission log updated.
Squadron reporting. Squadron reporting.
To zoom out from a system, click on the zoom icon located on the command bar.
Mission log updated.
Whenever you capture a planet, you will be rewarded with credits. Credits can be used to purchase new units, structures, and upgrades. You will receive money from all of the planets under your control at the end of each galactic day. The more planets that you control, the more credits you will receive.
Unlike the Empire, we do not prey on other systems to support our cause. Instead, we prefer to acquire the bulk of our tactical resources in a way that undermines the Empire itself. Fortunately for us, our spy network provides us with the advantage of being completely aware of all Empire-controlled systems within the immediate area. A smuggler on Bothawi has agreed to support our cause and can be deployed to Nalhutta. Direct our smuggler to siphon credits from Nalhutta.
Mission log updated. Hiring smuggler.
Smugglers are spy units that can be used to increase your credit supply without the need to capture planets. A smuggler is available on Bothawi because a cantina is present on this planet. To steal credits from the Empire, drag the smuggler unit to the steal credit slot on Nalhutta.
Mission log updated.
Moving into position.
Good. As long as our smuggler is deployed at Nalhutta, we can expect to see an increase in our credit reserves. We have built all that we can with our current resources. Since we acquire our resources in ways that undermine the Empire, we will need to get technology advancements from the Imperials. These droids should be able to assist you in this task.
The Rebel Alliance gains new technology by stealing it directly from Imperial planets. Move R2-D2 and C-3PO to the steal slot on Nalhutta to steal technology from the Empire.
Mission log updated.
Hover the mouse cursor over any item that you wish to receive detailed information for, and a tooltip will be displayed. Choose a technology to steal from the Empire by selecting it from the available list. Whenever the Rebel faction exhausts all possible technology options, they will advance to the next technology level.
New construction options available.
Good. We must also improve our hold on Bothawi by constructing defensive structures.
A power generator will be built automatically for any structures that require power to function, including base shield generators. Remember, you can zoom in on a planet to see any units and structures that you may have built.
Mission log updated. Construction complete.
Now that our defenses are in place, we should take steps to reinforce the neighboring planet of Tatooine. Unfortunately, the space above Tatooine has been blockaded by an Imperial fleet, so we will need to make use of a raid fleet. Unlike normal fleets, raid fleets do not initiate space combat on enemy systems. Using raid fleets allow us to reinforce or assault systems which are blockaded by enemy fleets.
The Rebel Alliance can use raid fleets to bypass space battles within enemy territory by moving directly to a planet's surface. This allows the Rebel Alliance to reinforce friendly planets blocked by enemy space units or even capture undefended enemy planets.
Create a raid fleet using some of our newly recruited infantry and reinforce the defenses on Tatooine.
To access a more detailed view of a selected planet, click on the zoom in icon located on the minimap.
Mission log updated.
Create a raid fleet by dragging the ground unit shown here into orbit. To move a unit into orbit, simply drag and drop the units to the desired fleet position.
Mission log updated.
You will now need to bypass the Empire space units positioned above Tatooine. To do this, simply drag the Rebel raid fleet from Bothoe to the raid slot located on Tatooine. This will place the infantry units directly on the surface of Tatooine.
Mission log updated.
On my way.
Invasion commencing.
Well done. The additional support at Tatooine should allow our forces there to endure any sudden Imperial attacks.
Before you can complete your training, you must also learn how to command space forces in battle. Let's examine another conflict, this time from the perspective of the Empire. In this case, the Empire faction is attempting to eliminate a Rebel space station located in orbit above Kashyyyk.
An Imperial peacekeeping envoy deployed to Kashyyyk was assaulted by an unusually organized dissident group. This warrants our full attention. I'm sending you to investigate a derelict space station being used as a haven by these rebels. Direct this space fleet to Kashyyyk and reinforce the Imperial units already en route. Eliminate all resistance and report back to me at once.
To attack the Rebel space forces located above Kashyyyk, drag the Imperial fleet from Nal Hutta to Kashyyyk. Moving a fleet into orbit above an enemy planet will initiate a space battle.
Mission log updated.
Location confirmed.
Tactical battle imminent.
To take control of the space above Kashyyyk, you will need to eliminate all of the enemy forces and base structures. You will be escorted by an Imperial officer on this mission. This officer will provide you strategic advice from the safety of his shuttlecraft.
Welcome to the front line. We've pinpointed their base of operations and are standing by. Our orders are to eliminate this station by any means necessary. We will need to navigate through this hazardous terrain to reach our destination. Stay away from the asteroid fields and stay alert. This area is ripe for an ambush, and we can't afford to take any losses. Follow me.
Select your units by left-clicking on them, and then issue a move command by right-clicking on the desired map location. Scroll the tactical display by moving your cursor to the edge of the screen or by using the keyboard arrow keys.
Tartan Cruiser reporting. Location confirmed. Advancing.
Good job. Watch out for those nebula fields. They'll wreak havoc on our auxiliary systems.
Confirmed.
Nebula fields are swirling clouds of gas and dust that can be found in space. These fields do not damage ships, but they do disable the use of unit abilities, such as the power to weapons ability.
Forward. Awaiting command.
Enemy forces ahead.
Awaiting your command. Cannons armed.
Incoming hostiles. Remember your training. Divert power to weapons.
Use the Tartan cruiser's power to weapons ability to increase the ship's rate of fire and destroy the fighter squadrons blocking your path. Select your Tartan cruiser units, then click on the power to weapons ability icon located on the command bar.
Imperial scouts reported a frigate ship along with a bomber squadron in the vicinity. Take a moment to allow our shields to regenerate before advancing.
Shield status is reflected by a blue bar on a ship's health meter. Shields regenerate over time for most space units. Hull status is reflected by a green meter. Unlike shield damage, hull damage does not regenerate over time. If a ship's hull is destroyed, the ship will be destroyed.
Full speed.
Okay, let's move out. Follow me.
Moving. Right away.
Maximum fire! There they are. The frigate has been damaged, probably by one of our patrols. If those bombers manage to attack us first, their torpedoes will tear our hulls apart.
Destroy the hard points on larger ships and space stations to disable critical parts like weapons, shields, and engines. Only units with torpedo projectiles, such as bombers, can attack hard points on a ship or structure while the shields are functioning.
Destroying laser. Firing on their lasers. Target confirmed. Destroying lasers. Firing on their lasers. Concentrating firepower.
Frequency open. Moving out.
Assault fleet, this is Imperial Acclimator 019er. We are en route to reinforce your position and are awaiting your coordinates. Confirm.
Good. We will need reinforcements to commence with our assault. Deploy our reinforcement ships and bring more firepower to bear against that space station.
To bring reinforcements into a battle, select the Reinforcement button. Then drag and release the ships into space from the reinforcement window. Remember, reinforcements can only be released in open space, away from enemy structures and other hazards. Double-click on any unit to select all visible units of that same type. Smaller units, such as fighter squadrons, can be selected by clicking on either the squadron icon or on the individual units.
Reporting in. Crews are online. Ready. Navigating. What are your orders? Watch out for those ion fields.
Ion fields are swirling clouds of charged gas and dust that can be found in space. These fields do not damage ships, but they do disable.
Be careful. This doesn't look like the work of space rabble. The shields on that derelict space station have been restored. Approach the station with fighter squadrons to draw its fire, and use other units to eliminate the remaining hardpoints.
For the Empire.
Yes, sir. Fire from.
Acclimator ships contain TIE fighters and TIE bombers, as well as the power to weapons ability to help you destroy the rebel space station. Small fighters are useful against space stations because of their speed and small size. Destroy the shield generator hardpoint for enemy ships and space stations to disable their ability to regenerate shields, This will make them more vulnerable to attack and easier to destroy. To view this battle from a cinematic perspective, select the cinematic camera option located on the command bar.
Move to attack. Order confirmed. Destroy the shield generator. Our target priority is the laser cannons. Lasers are our target.
Excellent work. Let's return to base.
Since there are no rebel forces on Kashyyyk, the Empire can capture the planet without entering into a land battle. Whenever you capture a planet, you will be rewarded with credits, as well as the ability to support more units. The more planets that you capture, the larger your forces can become.
It appears the rebels we encountered on Kashyyyk have fled the system. Clearly, this petty rebellion is far less organized than I had originally thought. Take these forces, capture Kashyyyk, and report back to me immediately. Considering that there is absolutely no resistance on Kashyyyk, even you should have no problem with this simple task.
To move a fleet across the galaxy, drag the fleet icon to the space.
Excellent.
Capturing Kashyyyk has increased the total number of units that you can build, as well as the number of credits that you collect at the end of every galactic day. A trade route now connects Kashyyyk and Nal Hutta, increasing the total number of credits generated by the connected planets. Trade routes also increase the movement speed of any friendly fleets traveling along their path.
Now that we control Kashyyyk, we can use our newfound credits to improve our assets on Nal Hutta. See to it at once.
Upgrading your space station will make it a stronger defensive structure and will also allow you to support more units. Switch to space production mode by selecting the Space Production tab. Then build a space station by clicking on the space station icon.
Mission log updated. Building started. Construction complete.
Unlike those vile rebels, we do not poach technology from others, nor do we kidnap scientists. Construct a research facility and begin research on technology level 2.
Unlike the rebels, all Empire-based technology is dependent upon the presence of base structures, known as research facilities. Switch to land production mode by selecting the Land Production tab. Then build a research facility by clicking on the research facility icon.
Mission log updated. Construction complete.
Upgrading your technology level will provide you with access to new units, structures, and upgrades. Switch to land production mode by selecting the Land Production tab. Then, upgrade your technology level by clicking on the Upgrade Technology icon.
Mission log updated.
Apparently, a moth on Coruscant has detected an anomaly within our quarterly reserve reports. Considering that I personally oversee all of your credit transactions, there can be only one explanation. There is a smuggler in our midst. Direct a bounty hunter from the local Hutt Palace to eliminate the smuggler on Nal Hutta.
Whenever the total credit value of a planet is modified, it will be visible at the planet itself. In this case, the credits generated at Nal Hutta have been reduced by the presence of an enemy smuggler.
Mission log updated. Hiring bounty hunter.
Bounty hunters are spy units that can be used to neutralize enemy hero units. A bounty hunter is available on Nal Hutta because a Hutt palace is present on this planet. To neutralize the enemy smuggler, drag the bounty hunter to the neutralize hero slot located on Nal Hutta, and then select the unit to be neutralized.
The captured smuggler has proven to be uncooperative. Regardless, his ship's logs reveal he could only have originated from a nearby system. Deploy as many probe droids as needed to locate his employers.
In order to receive information on nearby enemy systems, the Empire must use probe droids. Whenever probe droids are deployed to the surface of a planet, information about that planet will be revealed to the Empire.
Mission log updated. Constructing unit.
You have found pirates. While they are hostile to the Empire, these aren't the rebels you're looking for. Gather more information about nearby enemy planets by deploying Imperial probe droids to the ground slot of each planet.
We will extend the search radius to other nearby planets. Find them. Do not fail me again.
Constructing unit.
Unbelievable. More dissidents. Prepare our forces. We must stamp out this uprising immediately. If we are to succeed in our assault, we will need to employ a strategy of my own making. One that requires both skill and cunning. One that will assure us a victory with minimal risk. We will direct our acclimator ships to unleash their bomber squadrons upon the rebels until they submit. And then, when they march, arms raised from their pitiful, smoldering base, we will bomb them again!
Most Imperial ships, such as acclimator ships, contain bomber units. Whenever bomber units are positioned in orbit above an enemy planet, bombing run attacks may be used while you are involved in a land battle at that planet.
Mission log updated. Vehicle in production. Constructing unit.
Crews are online.
Larger ships, like acclimators, have a significant impact towards the maximum unit capacity provided by planets and space stations. Once that limit is reached, you cannot create new units until more planets are acquired.
To ensure a certain level of competence on this mission, I require a senior officer to accompany you. Recruit a field commander from the Officer Academy on Nalhutta.
Field commanders provide combat bonuses to all friendly units within a battle. You must have access to an officer academy in order to recruit a field commander. Switch to land production mode by selecting the land production tab. Then build an officer academy and field commander by clicking on the appropriate icons.
Mission log updated. Beginning construction. Construction complete. Training.
Awaiting your orders.
Yes, good. All of the necessary components are finally in place. The rebels won't know what hit them, and Ryloth will be mine. Excellent. Now, consolidate the land and space fleets on Nalhutta so that we may commence with the assault.
Mission log updated.
Deploy units to the surface of Ryloth. Take no prisoners.
To initiate a land tactical battle, drag the fleet into the land slot on Ryloth. Remember, while you have bomber units in orbit above the planet, you will also have access to bombing runs.
Mission log updated.
Confirmed.
Tactical battle imminent. Invasion commencing.
Ready for recon. Gearing up.
This clearing is suitable for use as a reinforcement point. Secure the area and deploy our scouts. We'll launch the assault from this position.
The area surrounding a reinforcement point must be clear of enemies before it may be captured. Remember, you can use build pads to purchase defensive structures in strategic areas, such as this reinforcement point.
Watching for the enemy.
We'll back you up.
Speeder bikes can use the thermal detonator ability for hit-and-run attacks. To use this ability, select a speeder bike unit and then click on the thermal detonator ability icon located on the command bar.
Ready to move. Awaiting destination.
Land reinforcements can only be deployed in controlled areas, known as reinforcement points. Conquering reinforcement points is of particular strategic importance in this game. The amount of units you can bring into any reinforcement point is determined by that point's capacity, denoted by the number shown. Once you reach that capacity, you can no longer land units at that particular reinforcement point. You will have to conquer another reinforcement point to bring down more units. When invading the surface of a planet, it is vital you maintain control of as many reinforcement points as possible, since you can only deploy reinforcements near areas that you control. If the defender gains control of a reinforcement point, you will not be able to deploy reinforcements at that location.
A sandstorm. It will, no doubt, prove to be a nuisance, but it will not stop us from achieving victory.
Foul weather can reduce the effectiveness of your units. You must account for weather changes whenever you are engaged in battle on a...
Good work. They'll think twice before interfering in Imperial affairs. Now, about that Rebel base. The Rebels apparently have a base shield generator. Clever, but it won't stop us for long. Locate the power generator supplying power to that shield and destroy it.
Base shield generators provide the defender with a significant advantage by blocking enemy blocks.
The base shield generator is down. All units, attack the Rebel base.
Roger that. Destination is...
Use your forces and special abilities, such as bombing runs, to destroy enemy turrets, buildings, and other base defenses.
Bombers standing by. Commencing bombing run.
Form up. Awaiting orders. Copy.
I copy.
An excellent target.
Reporting. Order acknowledged.
Affirmative, sir. Let's move out. Scout trooper reporting. Roger that. Targeting rebels.
Yes, Commander.
We've got them in our scopes. I'm en route. Target acquired.
Providing backup.
Warm up.
Order, sir.
Yes, Commander.
System conquered.
Good. Very good. Not only has the Rebel base been destroyed, but we now control all of the resources provided by Ryloth. Grand Moff Tarkin will be pleased to hear of my success. You are dismissed.
Invasion commencing.
This non-interactive tutorial will provide you with the information needed to play land-based skirmish games within Star Wars: Empire at War. Let's begin with unit production.